A portion of today's video is brought to you by Spam. As our needs for energy and food continue to rise, we're revisiting the sunny topic of agrivoltaics, or using land to grow food and host solar panels at the same time. Experiments in this hot space have had some really promising results over the last year, like using new technology to double food production and implementing AI systems to better harvest sunlight. But is getting twice the usage out of the acreage really a win-win? It takes a certain type of veggie to really thrive in these environments, and the upfront costs for this technology can be crippling. Can tech and AI really enter the food production industry and reshape it like they've done with so many others? I'm Matt Ferrell. Welcome to Undecided. From growing cannabis faster with LSC panels to creating autonomous solar panel cars that can navigate the intricacies of farmland, new developments in agrivoltaics are making waves and even expanding the definition of the field. We're about to go on a deep dive about the latest advancements, but if you're looking for a broader explanation of the topic, you might want to check out my previous video on agrivoltaics, which I'll link in the description. But for now, let's briefly recap why this field is booming. It's predicted by the Department of Energy that by 2050, ground-based solar technologies will require about 10 million acres of land to produce the power that we need to reach our decarbonization goals. That's the equivalent to about 0.5% of the total space across the contiguous United States. And despite that huge number, researchers aren't too worried about setting aside land with optimal conditions, and one big reason behind that is agrivoltaics, or getting dual use out of the land for both food and energy production. While using open space just for solar farms could run into opposition because it overlaps with prime sites for agricultural work, a study run by Michigan Technological University in 2021 found that over 80% of respondents would be more likely to support solar development in their community if it combined production of both energy and agriculture. In fact, in June of last year, China banned use of farmlands exclusively for energy production, but it allows it in special cases where it's being used for food production too, or agrivoltaics. This lands us on why agrivoltaics works and the mutual benefits that it provides. While plants need sunlight to grow, after a point, more light leads to diminishing returns. It can dry them out instead of contributing to photosynthesis. Solar panels placed above these crops can both absorb the extra light that would otherwise be wasted throughout the day and provide some shade for the crops to drop temperatures and offer a break from the heat. All this translates into less water usage for farmers, saving them money while also doubling the use of their land. It can also increase the yield for certain types of plants, like tomatoes, and help farmers diversify their income with a new type of cash crop, energy production. But this is where it gets really interesting. What if we were to use AI to track weather patterns, measure and optimize crop growth, and even use the panels to protect these crops from dangerous weather? How far can we push this? Well, first, let's take a look at the recent developments in the field. Government-sponsored policies like the one in China that I mentioned earlier have helped to push agrivoltaic projects in countries across the world. From rewarding state-sponsored contracts in France for energy producers, new laws like the Renewable Energy Act in Germany, and publishing guidelines for the design, construction, and operation of agrivoltaic plants in Italy. There's also been some major advancements for promising tech in the field. While luminescent solar concentrators or LSC panels have been around and evolving for decades, they recently made some pretty big waves in agrivoltaics. LSC panels are semi-transparent, meaning sunlight passes right through them. And while that light is traveling through the panel, some of it's captured and concentrated along the edges, where a photovoltaic cell converts into electricity. You can probably see where I'm going with this. Combining LSC panels and crop growth holds some promise for some electrifying and mostly clear wins. But before we get to that, there's another technology that can help you level up the solar and battery setup on your house, and that's today's sponsor, Span. I'm building a new super energy efficient home with solar panels and home energy storage. And one of the things that's going to be key to my new setup is something that I've been living with in my current home for almost a year and a half now, and that's a Span smart panel. I absolutely love this thing. It really fills in a huge missing piece of the home energy puzzle. If you have solar and home battery, like a Tesla Powerwall, Span can prioritize which circuits get shut off in a blackout to maximize your battery storage. You don't have to have a separate permanently wired critical loads panel. You can adjust things on the fly right from the app. And Span has just announced it will integrate with Enphase starting in late April. You can pair the Enphase IQ battery with Span to level up your home battery backup experience. If you're interested in getting a Span smart panel or their new Span Drive EV charger for your house, check out the link in the description. Thanks to Span and to all of you for supporting the channel. Now back to how LSC panels are changing the future of farming. The new concept of agri-LSC, or using LSC panels specifically with greenhouse architecture, was presented in the Solar Energy Journal just in October. The idea of agri-LSC is to allow visible light that crops use for photosynthesis to pass through the panel. while capturing wavelengths of light that are unusable for plants like infrared and ultraviolet, and converting them into electricity or even transforming them to aid with crop growth. Some companies are even off to the races exploring this already. UbiGrow is a transparent film that implements a method of LSCs to increase yield for everything from strawberries to cannabis by up to 20%. They recently teamed up with solar module company Helion to add UbiGrow film to solar panels, simultaneously generating electricity from low light while aiming to increase plant yield. Fingers crossed it works, because we'll need more food for the munchies. And our growing population, of course. So if there's government backing and new advanced technologies starting to enter the scene, what's the holdup? Well, probably to the surprise of nobody, the biggest barrier to agrivoltaic farms is cost. Money makes the world go round. You've probably seen it yourself if you're considering installing solar panels in your home. While the cost of solar alone can be expensive, agrivoltaic projects come with an even hotter price tag. Most agrivoltaic farms that use motorized solar trackers need tracking software that involves complex AI systems. Not emotionally complex, like Bing's AI chatbot telling a New York Times reporter to leave his wife, but sophisticated systems that utilize custom-made algorithms to optimize UV and crop conditions. And this, of course, adds to the price tag of the setup. Now, meanwhile, project developers have to jump through hoops to get the farm started, from working with the state to determine a price for any electricity sold, to creating custom development plans and working through legal issues in a developing field. It takes a lot of time, negotiations, and permitting to get things off the ground. Of course, this all translates into costs here too. Now, finally, if the panels are being horizontally mounted, they need to be above a certain height in order to allow farm equipment to pass underneath them as they harvest crops. Now, this leads to more material needs, and the mounting structures for these panels are not yet mass-produced, so they're harder to find and more expensive to create, at least at the moment. Now, in a study quoted by the Department of Energy, researchers in Germany estimated while ground-mounted panels cost an average of 572 euros per kilowatt, which is about $611, and a required investment of 486,000 euros per hectare, which works out to about $520,000, an agrivoltaic system with elevated modules costs about 1,234 euros per kilowatt, or about $1,319, and an investment of about 802,000 euros per hectare, which is about $857,000. It's almost double the cost of the original. And these numbers seem really high compared to what we saw in our previous video on agrivoltaics, where a study in Applied Energy quoted the difference as just 10 to 20%. And the costs seem to range wildly, and this comes down to everything from steel prices, adjusting materials to handle geographical problems like wind, labor costs, and safety precautions. Different vendors will provide hugely different estimates, which impact where and when the projects can get started. It's also still early days for agrivoltaics, and new things like this usually start out expensive and then drop in cost over time. But these high numbers limit agrivoltaic system developments and testing in countries with smaller economies, which not only restricts who can start an agrivoltaic farm, but preventing additional research the field needs to develop. Speaking about limited research, it's worth mentioning that we've only found ways for certain crops to benefit from agrivoltaics so far. Shade-tolerant crops like lettuce, peppers, and tomatoes saw increased yields in a 2019 study from the University of Arizona by up to 300%. However, other crops like grain, watermelons, or corn want to be in the sun most of the day. And then there are some more finicky crops that really need a specific amount of light and shade throughout the day, so let's throw some shade on those plants. How does AI measure, optimize, and protect crops? Well, let's ask. Hey, ChatGPT, how do we optimize that sun, shade, and moisture for every type of plant? Okay, it's not that simple, but AI is helping us to improve growing conditions in agrivoltaic farms. The past year for AI has been nuts. From an industry that was associated with reading voiceovers, we've landed in a place where AI writes term papers, creates art, and even produces culture. Okay, maybe culture producer is too generous a name for a meme-making robot, but the rise of AI can't be denied. It's no wonder this tech has even entered the world of agrivoltaics and helped to level it up. Although sensors have been built into solar panels since the beginning, algorithms are now being used in agrivoltaic farms for everything from keeping crops warm at night to deploying nets to protect them from pests. Now, of course, they're also measuring sunlight and using data to adjust to different crops' needs too. One company leading the pack with this technology is SunAgri. They say their AI system can determine the ideal tilt of panels according to sunshine and water requirements, then adjust to the growth model of the crop, soil quality, and weather forecasts throughout the day. Just last year, they launched an experimental project worth 2.5 million euros across an area of 4 hectares that included mounted solar panels, which automatically deployed nets to protect apricots, cherries, and nectarines from hailstorms. Many of the planning details, or rather annoying drawbacks that we spoke about earlier, are solved by the company by assigning a rep to work through the administrative procedures. And to prove their results, SunAgri sets up a control plot on your land so that you can compare yield and results, which is a cool little feature that can help push research in the field further. SunAgri's claim to fame comes from a 2019 experiment in which the dynamic agrivoltaic system was used to cover French vineyards under the threat of climate change, spring frost, and rising temperatures. 280 panels with a generation capacity of 84 kilowatts were placed above a vineyard that measured conditions and adjusted the amount of light that the vines received throughout the season. Even through heat waves in 2019, the grapes grew normally and water demand was reduced by 12 to 34% for the sheltered vines, thanks to a reduction in evapotranspiration, which is water evaporating from the soil and transpiring from the plants. It's also claimed that the aromatic profile of the grapes was improved in the agrivoltaic farm, that the grapes produced 13% more anthocyanins, which are red pigments, and they were 9 to 14% more acidic. I'm not exactly a wine connoisseur, so we'll have to trust all the experts on this, but if AI has the potential to make our food taste even better, I'll toast that. Okay, so we spoke a lot about how solar panels can be mounted above crops and tilted accordingly to optimize the amount of light the plants get throughout the day, thanks to AI systems. But what if we used a simpler technology to constantly move the panels around instead, so that optimizing light became less of a concern? Well, harvester, okay, just a side note, is it pronounced harvester with a two, or is it hydrogen harvester? I'm just gonna call it harvester, and I wish companies would stop getting cute with their names. But Harvester has created a carbon-neutral solar car, basically a group of solar panels on wheels that autonomously move around a farmer's land to generate sustainable energy throughout the day. It can navigate ditches, fields, and tall grass, and since it rotates between plots of land, it has the potential to be used for different types of crops that overhead solar panels can't yet benefit. The team is marketing harvesters as an additional crop that farmers can add to their repertoire, again doubling the use of the land that they own without impacting their crop yield. Now, the solar cars store energy as hydrogen, and the company claims this will refund farmers on their purchase over time as they sell the energy back. After the hydrogen is collected, it's eventually used for clean energy. It can be sold to third parties, agricultural cooperatives, energy corporations, industries, or even used by the farmers themselves. The potential for agrivoltaics, advancements in the field, and AI implementations have been promising, but there's still a ways to go when it comes to fully deploying these systems and putting them into practice. While the technology has evolved over the last couple of years, and new policies are starting to make a push, it still may take some time for agrivoltaics to become more mainstream. Win-win scenarios can happen, but it's going to take some serious investigation into how to best optimize agrivoltaics for different plants, people, and regions. So do you think agrivoltaics is worth pursuing? Jump in the comments and let me know. And be sure to check out my follow-up podcast, Still to be Determined. We'll be discussing some of your feedback. If you like this video, be sure to check out this one over here. And thanks to all my patrons who get ad-free versions of every video for your continued support. And thanks to all of you for watching and commenting. I'll see you in the next one.